Welcome back, TOWF Later, folks. Je suis Officer Gregg and Jeff out here today. Hey, we're going to be trying out some cool little test. We've got 100 little Tyvek envelopes. These are the mailer style envelopes you see at FedEx. They don't feel like plastic, they don't feel like paper. They're somewhere in between. Super strong material, you can't tear it with your hands. We're going to see if 100 of these things will stop a 1 ounce slug. This is a Federal 3-inch true ball 1 ounce slug. So let's see if we can stop it. 100 envelopes.
I might mention it's 1,700 feet per second.
Yeah, that's pretty dang fast.
Yeah.
That's just enough feet. That's like 5 or 6 millimeters, right?
Yeah.
100 of these envelopes actually is 200 layers, remember. So 200 layers of Tyvek. And then we've put the old body armor behind Doug so that we don't mess up his beer stained shirt. So.
And when you're doing bulletproof tests, don't use your friend as your target.
No.
Use Doug or something.
No, we're not out for YouTube hits like that. So
yeah.
We didn't want to put anybody live in there. So we're going to see if this 3 inches of Tyvek paper would make a good ballistic vest for law enforcement officers.
Well, if it'll stop a slug, you know.
Yeah, this would be an awfully bulky vest under a uniform. You should send it to Matt at Demolition Range.
Okay, I'm ready. Moment of truth.
All right, here we go. Oh my, that has some recoil. All right, here we go.
Did it save Doug's life?
1 ounce slug burrowed in there. I feel something hard in there though.
Uh-oh, that's...
Let's take off the bungees. Move this back.
Oh.
Made it through the paper.
Went through 200 layers. Actually, I think it was like 400 layers.
Of course, the vest stopped it. There's a nice hot hole in there. But yeah, it plowed right through there.
It didn't even slow it down. I was thinking, okay, this stuff is like spider webs the way it's constructed.
Well, that's what I was feeling.
Oh, the wadding even almost went through.
Hey, look at there.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Tyvek envelopes
will not make a good vest for law enforcement. So next time you're running down to the post office with your mail-in orders.
Hey, we had to try it though. There was like a rumor out on the internet saying that these are bulletproof and I don't know who started that rumor, but...
I think Rage Against the Machine, didn't they make a suit out of this once for the Grammys or something?
I don't know. I don't...
Out of FedEx.
I don't watch pop culture. Where'd the slug end up? Is it in that Kevlar vest?
Well, here's the true ball.
Oh, the true ball went through.
Whoa.
Oh, boy.
Let me see why you're digging that. I think I found
That's something they put in the slug to do something. To charge you extra quarter, I think.
Yeah, it's true too. There's no lies with that ball at all. Right there is a really hot little slug. And look at the divot in the back where that ball was sitting.
Yes, sir. Well, there you go. Don't make a bulletproof vest out of Tyvek, no. Ladies and gentlemen.
Would it make a sweet little ashtray?
I would have thought that I would have stopped it, but it didn't.
Cut right through. Tyvek.
So don't get any crazy ideas, kids.
So if you send in your submissions to TOWF Later, Mouse, we're going to mail you
a ventilated envelope.
Yeah, just an envelope. Just an envelope. Get a hole in it.
Don't say that. They'll be emailing me asking for
we're
them.
We're going to send you one of these holes because here's the envelope.
You could dig through my trash and take them all out if you want. Want these?
That's right.
Buddy. Wow. That's surprising because that stuff is very tough.
Hit Doug right in his Houston.
He's so looking so cool today.
Well, he's got his Schmedium shirt on from his... the spring break at Houston.
Yeah, yeah.
Those little sideburns.
God. He's rocking, I think.